Hello and welcome to another episode of the Internet Said So, a show where we take randomly shocking, weird, absurd, fast, fast, trivia, and personal stories and we talk about it. And today's
topic
is
waking up in the morning.
Waking up in the morning. We have raided Saurabh Pal's channel.
Correct.
Guys, how do you all feel? Aaj apna episode bhi launch ho raha aur uske pehle apan dusre channel pe bhi jaake kar rahe. So yeah, this is
it feels so nice.
Main chat dekhne ki koshish kar raha hu taki mujhe pata chale ki hum log raid dhang se kar rahe hai ki nahi. But yeah, what's up? No, there are people watching. It's not a surprise. So this channel has fans.
More subscribers than the channel we do our podcast on.
But this is not like EIC's channel or SNG's channel where a lot of the subscribers are bought. These are authentic fans.
Tall claims, Neville. So good morning, guys. We just
shot
the podcast last night, and अपन सुबह उठ के वापस कर रहे हैं. तो कैसे लग रहा है आपको?
सौरभ को बुलाएगी रहने दे. हाँ, हम लोग ने टी-शर्ट भी बदला है. हम लोग ने सौरभ को बोला ये पॉइंटलेस है, छोड़ दे, हम लोग ये कर ले.
डूड, ये नेक्स्ट मंडे वैसे भी करना है यार. फकिंग लेट्स जस्ट डू इट नाउ.
Yeah, but technically then this makes it the 49th episode and what's happening at 12 o'clock is the 50th episode, which is just, we should be fucked up.
No. Like 51st.
I think we should call Saurabh on.
Yeah, yeah. But I just want to say, guys, less than 12 hours ago, we still hadn't started recording yesterday's episode.
Yeah,
just want to put that in perspective. All right, please welcome today's guest, Mr.
on his own channel.
On his own channel, give it up for Mr. Saurabh Pant, ladies and gentlemen.
Saurabh, just
what is happening in my channel? This is a shock. What's this unplanned thing? Oh my god, what are you guys doing here? I can't believe this.
Saurabh, you won't be able to believe it when you try to log into your channel again, bro.
We've been through this.
Is it called doing a KT?
Last time we had a small guy with us on a screen.
Good morning, Pant, Saurabh.
Pant, actually, technically, now this looks like an SNG-ish thing because of, like, you know, just the exterior.
What Neville is trying to say is that this is the closest we'll get to a reunion. Okay.
Yes. because takla ho bhi.
Well, I'll zoom in a little bit more. So I need to put like, you know what? I really generally was thinking ki yaar main apne chehre pe thoda kajal laga ke thoda beard banaunga. But then I just gave up. And then I'll have a tattoo of Sonam Kapoor on my forehead or something.
Bro, what you said right now is how throughout my young life I tend to show I have a beard. Main kajal laga tha. You know, to fill in the gap between it so it looks like a proper beard.
But Thakur, you still need to put kajal. Is that
abhi better hai, bro. Abhi better hai. Abhi thoda aata hai daadi.
Yeah, at least you did it on a daadi. When I started losing hair, okay, main channel ke liye pata nahi kuch shoot kar raha tha, to the makeup person was trying to put like bhai paseene se nikal jayega. It was fuck on. This is no 3D level.
Aapka hair leak ho raha hai, sir.
Okay, for all those asking on the chat, Saurabh, do you not monitor your own chat? For all those asking on chat, Adar has a personal emergency and therefore couldn't be here. Also, the 4 screen is better than 5. The 5th person in the screen just makes it look ugly. So, yeah. You prefer this. Yeah.
So, never leave.
I wanted all along.
But yeah, so Adar is there. I mean, eventually something had to happen. It can't be a full reunion despite the leaks.
And it can't be a stream on Saurabh channel, bro. By the way, I was supposed to do this a month and a half ago. Okay? And it's a Sunday morning, 11 o'clock. Saurabh, me, Danish, I think Neeti and Anubhav. That was the lineup. And I slept at 5 o'clock. Okay? I said, no, bro. Stream ke liye utha hai. To 10 alarm rakke stream ke liye utha hai. Bahar aaya hai. But by the way, Saurabh, the reason there is no disturbance is I'm on Ethernet, not on my Wi-Fi. Yeah, because my Sai service is very fuck all. You will probably see it in the comments soon.
Sai service OP.
Okay. So, I'm sitting outside after sleeping for 4 hours. That no, Saurabh will stream. He is not logging in. So then I've had to call Saurabh on WhatsApp video. He took that video and kept it in front of the camera.
This is like, I don't know if you saw this stream. Somebody was doing an Instagram live. Ronak Kapoor from ESPN was doing an Instagram live with Rahul Dravid. Okay. Now, Rahul Dravid was completely unable to turn on Insta Live. Okay. But he was only able to do FaceTime. So now, Ronak has picked up the FaceTime call on his MacBook, has turned the MacBook towards his phone, and he's doing an Insta Live with Dravid like this. Yeah. Which is the best Insta Live I have seen.
Dravid can't start Insta Live.
No, I think that it's just one of those things. Like, he's not interested. Like, it's... So.
Dude, the number of firewall jokes. Plus,
firewall.
All the jokes. I can already imagine the firewall jokes. They're like, oh, firewall. Like, wall ko Instagram bhi nahi tod sakta. All this bullshit. Standard. But hey, listen. So, Thakur, I remember that I had to hold the phone to show people ki bhai wo aa raha tha. Aisa nahi hai ki usne ditch kiya hai, wo koshish kar raha hai. But there is no better and this we have to talk about. I discussed this with Kumar Varun also. We have to talk about Neville Shah coming on my podcast with Ramchandra Guha and asking the dumbest fucking question.
I asked one dumb question because I asked it. Look, apart from all the other questions, I asked one dumb question. Hold on.
What did he say?
So we had Ramchandra Guha, right? Eminent historian, ye wo, and Kumar Varun and me are like, dude, who else is so well, like knowledgeable? It has to be Neville Shah. So we've asked about like emergency and like all Nehru, sab purane sare
questions. I asked other questions also, okay, Panth, please. It was only the one question. Stop it.
This question to Ramchandra Guha after 1 hour 40 minutes of us talking to him is like, so listen, I live in my building, right? And next to my building, there are these slums. And these slums have not been rehabilitated. So what
That's
do I
not
do?
The
and
question.
Ramchandra Guha is like, do I look like a fucking broker to you, dude?
That's not the question. First of all, that's not the question. The question was, let me explain the question. The question was, I wanted to come in from Slum Rehabilitation Act of 74. Okay, that's what I was trying to come in from. Okay, where I was trying to say that, why isn't the act amended? What was the purpose of the act? What was the implication of the act? And why is the act not amended even till date? That was the purpose with which I was trying to come for. But I gave him an example instead of asking him the question. I told him, jaise ki mera jo ghar maine kharida hai, usme slum rehabilitation ka part complete hai, but the slums haven't moved in because the people are not coming in, blah, 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 because of a vote bank issue, all of that jazz. So what is the problem? Instead of asking him with the context of the act, because I was fully gobsmacked and starstruck. I'm not even kidding.
The constitution would start with mere building society mein jo democracy chal raha hai na, wo exact what is your opinion?
Yeah, I apologize. I apologize profusely. I couldn't help it. I was just fully starstruck. The other questions were good, okay, so it's fine.
Yeah, there was one question which is good. And like, so Ramchandra Guha, when he spoke to him, he's like, I'm like, hey, it's going to be 1 hour. He's like, what are we going to talk for 1 hour? And then it went on till 1 hour, 45 minutes, and he's like, still in the flow. And then Bawa came and he's like, you know what? I think we're done. He left.
I should write another book now.
No, but listen, I think I completely, dude, some of these people when you talk to, right, you don't understand when you're starstruck with someone. Right, you don't understand, like it's like if I met Jaspal Bhatti, for example, right, if he was alive, I would meri phat jati, yaar. I would be like, what question
I was
you
about to say,
person?
Then you'd be dead.
Yeah.
You met Jaspal Bhatti.
But when you said meri phat jati, I said, haan, genuinely, agar toh abhi Jaspal Bhatti ko milega, toh phatega.
You know, I sincerely know that Jaspal Bhatti and me will land up in the same place. I think he's going to be up there and I'm going to be sent down. By the way, I have to say, okay, coordinating X and G, okay, has given me a lot of empathy for Karan Talwar. I think he's a great man, a misunderstood person.
Why do you think we broke up? Because we all have stuff to do.
You know, it's taken Saurabh so long to get us on that I have come on twice. Okay, like that's how.
But technically, so have I, and so has Varun on a WhatsApp. Yes, so if you think about it. Just collectively together, it's a problem.
Yeah.
But Pat, you've been doing it every morning at 11, right?
Nahi re, shuruaat mein I started every morning and then I realized ki yaar aur bhi kaam hai life mein. Like, I'm not making that much from this to fucking warrant me coming only on this. So now it's 4 times a week. Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, Sunday.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So must Thursday ko we just confirmed KKR ex team director Joy Bhattacharya is coming on Thursday.
Wow.
And Saturday Sunday का अभी lock नहीं हुआ है, but it should be somebody fun. I'm getting in touch with some really strange people who are really fun.
तू जब cricket करेगा ना, मैं आ रहा है वापस.
हाँ ना, Thursday का वापस अगर आने हैं. Thursday को भी talking about IPL.
Bro. अभी भाई speaking of IPL is starting bro September.
Yeah, UAE. And the thing is, it's got two. There's two IPLs parallelly happening. There is the main IPL. There's IPL that the men's IPL happening and the female and the women's IPL also happening parallelly. From the 1st to the 9th of November. So there's two IPLs parallelly happening.
सही है.
But the women's one is more of a they're trying to work the like I think they're trying to figure out ki what the viewership for it is going to be.
No, see, last year also they had a small mini tournament, right? Like just before the IPL final towards the end where they did it. And what's also extremely gratifying slash I don't know if it's I mean I don't know there could be a positive and a negative to it. If there is the cynical person in me is like they're trying to also merchandise this, which is fine. But they're forcing sponsors to if you want the IPL, you also have to sponsor that. Like you can't just sponsor the main IPL. You have to put the money into the female IPL as well, which in some ways good, right?
Yeah, best strategy.
But they have to, no? I mean, because like right now they've not figured out the format. They've not figured out the format right now. Like last time, I think there were three exhibition or four exhibition matches, and this time they are doing I think about 8 or 9. So I think once they figured out, dude, like I remember Shefali, what's her name? Shefali Verma, right? Dude, I mean, from where, man? Like 17-year-old and they just come and start slamming it. I'm like, this is great. It was really entertaining to watch.
Can I tell you a story about a female cricket team that Shahid Shafi and me, okay? Manav, by the way, is the person responsible because he set up that gig for us, okay? We went to the ITC in Bombay and we have to do a show, okay? And this is like, as always, OML is like, no, हम लोग एक नया property खड़ा कर रहा है, amazing है, ये वो. Zakir कभी नहीं आएगा, Kanan कभी नहीं आएगा, लेकिन तुम लोग जाएगा क्योंकि amazing होने वाला है. So we went, okay. So Shahid and me are opening first show. First of all, look at the lineup. Shahid and me, both people who can't sell tickets. So we've gone. He's like, no, comfortably 80-90 people are going to be there. The manager has also told us this. They've said we've put flyers into the hotel. Guests have to come, etc., etc. And some insane fee on the booze that's going to be available during the show. Okay, so Shahid and I reach. The show is supposed to be at 8 o'clock. At 7:55, or the show is supposed to be at 9 o'clock. Whatever. 5 minutes before the show time, there is a guy who's a foreigner who's drunk and passed out like this. He's just gone and he's still got on his side table. He's got like a booze and peanuts and all open. There is one other table of four guys who are fully drunk, but Indians, but fully drunk in the sense they're loud. They've not passed out. They're having a conversation and stuff like that. I've sent videos of this to Manav where they're things. So the manager goes and says, sir, can you please quiet down? There's a stand-up show going to start. Okay, so that's it. There are six people in the bar. These five get up and leave. They're like, no, we don't want to see stand-up. We want to continue drinking. Where is the next bar? So they've gone to the next bar. After this, they force. So lots of things happen. They force a couple of people to come in. Yevo. Then finally, just to get us on stage, because we said that till 10 or 12 people are there, we're not going up. Right? Because all the things. They've called the Haryana under 18 girls cricket team who's staying in the hotel because there is a match going to happen to come down forcibly and watch the show.
Wow. Okay.
So they are not even they are not A, they have a match in the morning. B, they have absolutely no interest in stand-up comedy. And your introduction to stand-up comedy should not be Shahid Shafi or me. So these people they've been forced to come. They are all sitting and there's about 8 or 9 of these girls. And they're all like pretty much because obviously they're a clique and they're comfortable with each other. They're really sticking on one side only. And they're really close to each other on one side. Barring two people who are sitting at the back, right? And Shahid goes up first. I said, Shahid, don't fucking finish off all the cricket jokes. Okay, you better leave some for me. Fucker has spoken to every member in the cricket team. And has spoken to the two other couples who are there. So I have no chance to do any material. Shahid finishes. I go up. I'm doing my set. About 15 minutes into my set, they get up. About 5 minutes into Shahid's 5 minutes of Shahid's set left. three of them get up and leave. Into my set, all of them get up and leave. I was like, but I'm almost done. They're like, nahin, kal subah match hai, uske liye tayari karne hai. And they fucked off. Now I'm performing to four people who have no clue what the fuck is happening.
Now it's more awkward for you than it is for them.
Correct. Absolutely. Absolutely, bro. Absolutely.
It seemed to be the sole reason that they lost the match the next morning.
Yeah. Or they were so angry from the previous night that they demolished the opponent.
Yeah, dude.
The tactic tha baba, coach ka.
Yeah.
Dekha ke kill kar rahe. Abhi Mumbai Indians ko saath jaake perform kar.
Aaga gussa nikal rahe.
Dude, but this is like, I don't know entire set about how I performed in Antilla when Mumbai Indians was not winning one IPL. And after my performance, they won. So I do a whole flow about how I inspired them to win because I was so fuck all. So,
all of EIC had gone, or you had gone separately to do the show?
No, I used to go alone. Nah. They were like, who is EIC? Fucking go alone. Nah. Why do you want to get all these hanger-ons, these pylons?
I should have one point of contact.
Yeah. And by the way, EIC went solo later on. And that show went off better. And I was like...
Dude, they were telling me they did that Modi song or something. And they've actually got in a request from the Ambani family ki wo Modi wala gana karo. And the thing is, they can do it, na? Modi wala joke kar, to Modi khud bedh ke hasega, na? Kuch bolega. So they've gone and performed that in front of the Ambanis, which I thought was sick. और उन लोगों को 5 मिनट करना है लेकिन देखो पैसा मिलेगा 10x ऑफ योर 1 आवर शो व्हिच इज अमेजिंग तो प्लीज अगर आप देख रहे हो तो मुझे भी बुलाओ.
I don't know if you've ever done one of these shows. So we were doing this show for this, I think, Daredevil's IPL team. And the show was generally very interesting. Because sabki gaand lagi and surprisingly, except me, okay? So basically, what the event manager was like, sir, are yaar, ek se kya kaam chalega? I'm like, bhai, 40 minute, hum do log kar sakte aaram se. They're like, nahin, yaar, pura laate hai na. Sab aap gaana wagera karo. I'm like, gaana wagera hum nahin kar sakte. He's like, theek hai, stand up karo. So the plan was 45 minutes, 5 comedians. Okay? And they wanted us to get on stage together to do something. So we figured out some bullshit at the end. So each person was scheduled to do, I think, and then show's about to begin. They're like, hum late chal rahe, to abhi 35 minute. What the fuck do this? So we are literally cutting acts like, Atul, you were supposed to do 6, you do 4.8, okay? And then Angad, you do this. And I think Angad, me, Atul, Sahil, I think, or all three of them tanked because it was Delhi Daredevils ka, I think Daikin is their sponsor. So they had got all the sales people from North India.
Oh God.
So Sahil is like, guys, anybody from South Mumbai here? Anybody feeling good? You guys watch anime? Anybody watches anime? They're like, dude, we live in fucking Ghaziabad. We don't watch anime, you chute. So Sahil eats shit. Then Atul, we were like, Atul, now Atul is old man. He's going to appeal to him. And Atul is like, ha, Siddhi, ha, fucking bastard, ha, humpy, and whatever the fuck he's doing. They're running to that also. Then Angad finally pulls out one cricket joke and they're like, okay, we understand this at all. Then I do my set, which somehow goes up well because I just do full cricket jokes. So what's happening is that Rishabh Pant is here. I think...
Saurabh Pant is on stage.
Saurabh Pant is on stage, which is a great moment. I fully milked that. I went on and on. To mera,
16
to mera bhai hai, to mera beta hai, to mera cousin hai, to mera pura parivar hai. We are married, just fucking everything. And we got paid like a pretty decent amount of money for that. Like we got, all of us got corporate rates for effectively performing on stage for 7 minutes.
Oh, wow. That's the dream.
IPL.
Yeah. Even more awkward, we get done and I'm standing next to Rishabh Pant because like I think this is 2-3 years back and I was already a fan of his. I'm talking to him and this one uncle comes, really drunk guy. He's like, "Arey, yeah, bahut achhi koshish ki tumne aaj beta." He's like,
No, but don't worry. I think in all fairness, he must have been talking to the team, thinking also Rishabh Pant. So.
But that's when it got worse. He went to Rishabh and he's like, "To beta, tum kya karte ho?" Like, this is, you're the sponsor, dude. You're the sponsor.
Ye Daikin wala hai koi?
Nahin, Daikin ka koi sales wala tha. The main Daikin guys were damn sweet. They were like really like into it. And even Rishabh Pant knows that this is like a guy who sells the air conditioners. So he's like, "Uncle, main cricket khelta hoon. Main left-handed batsman hoon."
That's sweet of him.
Yeah.
And oh, but then this uncle drags him. And he's like, "Arre Rishabh, aao hum, main introduce karta hoon apne doston ke saath." He's like, "I don't want to meet him." And then Rishabh Pant is talking to these uncles and looking at me and Angad like, "Rescue me." We have to rescue Rishabh Pant, which is great. But at
the end of that conversation, he came out with an AC. Like, they just told it to him. They're like, "Are you left-handed batsman or dual cooling AC?"
By the way, this connects to a really silly joke, which is one of those family kid jokes that I really enjoyed. My mom was a chief commissioner of the income tax, like now retired. So my wife told my son yesterday that that dadi was chief commissioner of income tax. My son has been confused the whole day, and he's like just looking very quizzically at me. He's like, "Papa, dadi was an air conditioner." And I was like, "How do you go from chief commissioner to air conditioner?" It's a real thing. By the way, let's take a couple of comments and then we'll move on because people are very excited. Shivam, who finally the gang has come, Tis fanboy. Oh-ho. Elon Pandey says, "Ask Baba how he enjoyed Saturday's final."
Yeah, Baba loved it.
Chelsky.
Yeah, tune mera wo wala padha kya? One more Dagla is disappointed.
फिर उसके बाद क्या है अंकुर विश्वास थैंक्स अ लॉट रिधि शास्त्री से सौरभ प्लीज पुट दिस कॉन्वर्सेशन ऑन स्पॉटिफाई द रीजन वी आर नॉट डूइंग दैट येट इज बिकॉज़ आई एम वेटिंग फॉर माय $100 million डील एंड
द रीजन व्हाई यू आर नॉट डूइंग दैट येट इज बिकॉज़ सौरभ पंत इज द लेजीएस्ट पर्सन ऑन द प्लेनेट
क्या बोल रहे हो यू दिस होल लॉकडाउन यू बीन डूइंग दिस लाइव्स ना सौरभ
अरे But yeah. as you can see, it's minimum effort. I have to log on to Zoom, send you a text like, baat karte hai, gaana se.
Yeah, he's not even pre-setting the link. He's not even pre-setting it. So that he can get more people. He doesn't care.
But to quote Ravi Shastri, it doesn't matter how they come, as long as they do, bro.
Yes. Sorry.
That's such a weird Ravi Shastri pickup line, right? Like, it's like him. Like he's discussing with Hardik and KL. Like it doesn't
matter how you come as long
except
as
except he's not talking about except he's not talking about girls. He's talking about beards.
Jayant Kaushak, please roast Neville more. Why roast Neville? Why?
First of all, Jayant ko bol. Agli baar usko mera edit karne ka na special. Rook abhi. Main roast karta hu usko.
Neville, I like your confidence that there is going to be another special.
There will be. Don't worry.
No, there will be. It's at the news side is damn fine.
Catch it live on his YouTube channel.
Saurabh Nair, thanks. Chirag Shetty, Tis guys, please do a podcast on history. You guys are great. Thanks. Baba Rock, Stream for Sanity.
Stream for Sanity is a thing I do once a month where I talk to therapists about mental health and other issues, etc., etc. I do it once a month. So I just finished my most recent one. It's on my channel. First of all, go to my channel and subscribe. Koi to log jayega.
Baba basically live streams his sessions. Yeah. Ja ke baithte hai, phir side na, aise camera chalo kar deta.
No. Dude, it's a lot of effort, okay? I fucking take questions anonymously in advance. I make it into blogs. No, it's a lot of work, dude. But it's fine. It's worth it. Sorry, Panch, finish your super chats, please.
We'll read three more and then we'll come to whatever. Sure. Adarsh Shadsadanand says, ask Neville about how Malabar Cadillac got made. Alok Barla says, we want to face off XNG versus Khan Masti. Bhai, tu coordinate kar. Main nahi karne wala.
Bro, you thought we were tough. You have to try getting Jose anything. Yeah.
Dude, I got Khan Masti, okay? Jose is confirmed, Cyril is confirmed, and Suresh Menon is confirmed. So Jose, the night before, and I've started promoting it. Jose is like, oh, should I have a shoot? I'm like, shoot hai toh paisa hai toh, I can't say anything to that. I'm like, theek hai. And Cyril, who happens to be one of my closest friends, is like, oh, bro, it's tomorrow, bro. You know, bro, I have this thing, bro. I'm like, what? He's like, a thing, bro. I can't come. I'm like, can you be more vague about this shit? And this is Suresh. And he's like, I'm Khan Masti. I can't even make jokes about semen without them around.
Jose is really tough. Usko teen baar message, char baar phone, 6 saal pehle pehle puchne. Hey, tu 2027 mein Wednesday ko free hai kya koi bhi? I think I can. Fir on Wednesday, hey bro, actually I have something else. How about next Wednesday?
Once Jose cancelled on us just by sending one emoji. You know that 40 wala emoji? He just sent a 40 wala emoji.
I mean, okay, so Jose can't make it. Why did he tell you? Yeah, he did send me.
Aniket Deshpande, Neville, you and KV were great, would be great additions to Saurabh podcast with journalists and historians. Dude, I will actually call you for the next one. I'm trying to get in touch with like a bunch of other historians also. So I agree. Nav Nair says, Adar had to apologize for a joke that most people would not consider offensive. Does this not set a bad precedent?
One second. I just want to say most people did consider it offensive, which is why he had to apologize, unfortunately. Yeah.
Harinder Mulwani says, hoping Baba will acknowledge at least now he never responds to my messages and many hearts I sent to him on the TIS channel. Okay, so now, fan of Baba's intelligence and understanding of things, abhi to bol kuch.
Hi. मैं बहुत awkward हो जाता है bro, ये क्या है ये सब, हाँ sorry हो गया तेरा, मैं
यो किसने gun point पे रखा है, कुछ बोल कुछ बोल. Hi.
You know, by the way, this is what I realized. Like, so Karunesh and me figured this out, is that the weakness of every comedian is not insulting their comedy, it's complimenting them repeatedly. Because we don't know how the fuck to respond. Like, Neville, you're an amazing, amazing comedian and just a great person.
When you say it, it sounds sarcastic. So it's fine. Yeah. Okay, I'll tell you Malabar Cadillac. Oh, no, you have more super chats.
Just last two. Saurabh, repeating t-shirts. Dude, I have like 4 t-shirts that I keep wearing and this podcast is exposed there. That I have just 4 t-shirts.
Bro, but you know, I can't believe how much people focus on the clothes you wear, okay? Because
dude, it's unreal.
Back during a Big Question podcast, I had worn a t-shirt. Okay? A regular Jack and Jones se kharida hua t-shirt. कमेंट में चार बार एक लड़के ने लिखा है, यू आर वेयरिंग द सेम टी शर्ट दैट केनी वोर इन अ स्केच आई डिड विद हिम अ ईयर बिफोर दैट. फिर उसने स्क्रीनशॉट लेके मेरे को फेसबुक डीएम पे भेजा है, सी दिस यू आर वेयरिंग. आई सेड या बट देयर टू, इट्स नॉट लाइक दे हैव ओनली मेड वन, और मैं केनी के घर जाके चोरी करके उसका. They've gotten a screenshot and put both together. Ki dekho tumne same kapda pehna tha.
Just have to appreciate this Byomkesh Bakshi's detective. Put them together and sent it to you as evidence.
Dude, how did you not do a who wore it better bullshit on Instagram polling? Like that's the immediate like who wore it better.
Dekho thoda social media game strong karna padega.
Okay, just last thing and then everybody else who's super chatting will come to you later. Yeah, thoda flow rakhne do. Please bring Shekhar Gupta from The Prince, is Nikhil Fatnani. I'll bring him soon. I will get in touch with him. Okay, he's coming tomorrow. I'm not confirmed this. I'm lying. I've not spoken to him.
All right. So, kya batane ke? Ha. So, Malwa Cadillac's a movie. When I was 21, I ended up doing I was doing a lot of theater. One randomly in a bar, one dude, one white dude, walked up to me and is like, would you like to star in a movie? And it was so shady. I was like,
that you said yes. It was so shady that you said yes.
Yeah. And I was like, I don't know. But then he's like, I've already locked Ranveer Shori and Ranveer has said yes. Would you like to be the second co-lead? So I was like, okay. And because we were all touring as a troupe together, it just sort of seemed like things. So I asked Ranveer. He's like, yeah. It'll be fun. Do it. No, it's a problem. So I did a film called Malabar Cadillac. It's never going to see the light of day, guys. Just so you know. The trailer is on my channel. You can watch it. Enjoy the trailer.
By the way, you have to see a skinny anorexic Neville. If you want to see that, Malabar Cadillac is for you.
Yeah, that's true.
Dude, by the way, this coordination of stuff, okay, I'm just very fascinated by it because I realized like one of the points when I realized that, and it was not a tipping point, but it was one of the points where I was like, I can't do this. it was a bunch of, mainly the reason I left EIC was because of money, because I needed to make more money and all that kind of shit, which is fine. But I remember coordinating East India Comedy All Stars. Okay, now the plan was that we are going to do 2 shows in one show, and scam the people and make them pay double, and we'll all make a fuck ton of money. And what it required is coordinating 7 people's schedules for a fucking month-long comedy tour. So I was like, fuck, you can't do corporates, you can't do anything. This is all you can fucking do. Like random people are like, hey, I have a corporate. I'm like, I just canceled the corporate, you bastard. That is my corporate duty, Fatul.
Atul, kitna corporate show karta hai, bro, Atul. Kitna corporate show karta hai. I think even in the pandemic, on Zoom, max corporate shows done by Khatri sahab.
Yeah. But you also do a crazy amount of corporate shows. You're a corporate favorite.
Pre-COVID. Pre-COVID.
But abhi tu Zoom pe nahi kar raha
hai. COVID mein ek kiya hai. Corporate ek kiya hai, sir.
And that's very surprising, dude. I thought people would be calling you more.
No, so, thanks, Saurabh, for rubbing it in.
Wait, what is the other question somebody had asked Neville, by the way? Some other Neville thing?
No, it was a compliment. And just follow me on, follow my YouTube channel. Thank you so much. Instagram, whatever it is. Thank you.
It's a compliment.
Hey, but Thakur, what are you doing during the lockdown? Like, I imagine you doing a lot of like something or the other because tera to wo brands ke saath bahut chalte rehta hai na waise bhi.
Brands chal raha hai. Kaam wise, so honestly, in the beginning, I thought nahi hoga, bro, zero kaam because we had no idea, right? Apna show hone wala hai, shoot hone wala hai, what? And as we went into the lockdown, I was supposed to shoot for two web series. They both got pushed. I was supposed to do my special for Amazon. Can't do that. So I say, ghar pe baitha tha, I didn't know what to fucking do. And everybody thought, well, those 21 days is all it's going to take for Corona to go, right? And April 14, we can all like party.
Like it's a bad habit.
Yeah. Bro, you fucking look at the thing and realize it's August. Ki kab Modi ji aaye the, bole 21 din ghar pe rehna, bahar mat jana, 5 mahine ho gaye, bro. So I've pretty much been at home. I ended up writing a fiction show. So that's one thing that that's the best thing that's happened to me, honestly, through the lockdown is ek saal pe I was sitting on this idea, but never got down to putting it on paper, creating a show bible, etc. So I managed to do that, created the show bible. Apna bhai Caustic came on board and we co-wrote the pilot. And now pitching chalu hai, so please, Netflix, Amazon, Sony Liv, Hotstar.
Whoever is up.
YouTube Live.
कोई भी ले लो कोई तो ले लो MX player हजार ऑल्ट बालाजी थोड़ा सेक्स डाल दूंगा नो प्रॉब्लम जस्ट कुछ तो ले लो
LinkedIn MX player Snapchat
anywhere that it can be streamed so वो चल रहा है then other than that just we've been doing the podcast shows on Zoom and whatever brand work comes along I just wish I had done a little bit more of content in the sense that Insta time pass content, right? Not just Wiki, but something else similarly. Because a lot of people, I think, during the lockdown have managed to nail that, right? Like, Aadhar ka boring tutorials, they go, Rahul ka building uncle, pretty much everything Danish is doing. So, I wish I had also done something like that. Usme main thoda hug diya hai, I feel. So, bhi...
Yeah, even I started a YouTube channel, which is unreal. With no comedy on it, just so you know. Huh.
So your normal channel. I mean, this is such an easy joke to say. Yeah? Such an easy joke to write.
I set it up.
Yeah. Yeah, like here is a setup. Enjoy
the punch. I'm so easily transferable to so many people.
Yeah, everyone. This joke about comedians telling another comedian that your comedy sucks is always such a fun, easy joke. Yeah. It's great. Dude, my favorite right now is, so I love Anubhav Pal, okay? And Anubhav Pal is trying to get his Instagram game on, okay? It's so bad that it's hilarious. Versus Anubhav sitting like, all right, today in history.
In history?
Yeah, something, no hashtags, no proper focus. Just Rolling Stones performed their first this thing today. What's up with that? Or something. And then you can start. It's like, Anubhav, please talk to us once before you start this stuff. We'll tell you how to use hashtags.
You know, I won't be surprised. I wouldn't be surprised if his caption ke end mein na he writes his name. Blah, 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 dash, Anubhav.
Oh my God. How have I not?
Dude, I'm dying to check it out. I think it'll be hilarious.
That's my mama.
Dude, Anupam Pal is suddenly got a great uptick on his Instagram and people are just following him ironically. He's like, what the fuck happened to him?
But yes,
I want to talk. Haan, bolna.
Like, how has it been with both the kids at home? All you guys are at home for the most part. How's it been? How's it been during the lockdown for you?
Sorry, I'm sorry. One sec, man. His contact email address, apart from his manager's address, is, and I am not lying, it is on his bio of his Instagram. It is intelligentindiancomedy@gmail.com. If there is a bigger snub than that in the history of time. Oh my god, dude. It's insane.
Dude, I remember Anupam once put up a Facebook post. He was trying to put up a poster of his show. What he had done was, he had copy-pasted the file folder link from his laptop. Oh. So I message Anupam, I'm like, Anupam, can you please just talk to one? This is embarrassing. We're putting file locations. I'm thinking this is
wrong. Yeah, Windows hidden files. AUD40.
Anupam should just have two grandchildren just for doing that. Like, they should just appear because he did that.
I said he should have grandchildren. Yeah, skip kar diya beech mein. Tere bete ko beta kab hua? Tu wohi nikal.
Jab maine wo link dala tha na, tabhi ho gaya.
That's such a great sketch, right? He puts it up and there's a knock on the door. Like, Papa, he's like, what the fuck happened?
But once like, Pal is in London only, no?
Nahi re, he's in Mumbai only.
Oh, he's come back.
Bandra,
I think he was in. I think he was in London, and then he came, and then I think 3 weeks ka wo sab hua. But yeah, with kids, it's damn weird, man. Because my son ka the classes have started, and he's 5, 3 year old. So they don't have classes.
Like school? Like school?
Haare, the low KG whatever. It's absolute like so. Dude, the big advantage of having kids in your house is that I'm not the most smart study person, but like. Because they're spending time with you, suddenly they are learning way more shit than they would normally do. Like my son and me are doing crazy like maths and all sorts of shit. Like we spent a whole week trying to figure out the total of all the numbers from 1 to 100. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 all the way till 100. And we spent a week doing that. And it's great fun.
Varun will surprise you. He'll know this. Huh. He'll know this in 2 seconds. Give it
no,
to
no.
him.
No, Baba, aisa, he's Mrs. Shakuntala Devi.
Please.
कैसे करूं बट 100 नंबर है बाबा टू ऐड एवरीथिंग थोड़ा टाइम लगेगा लेकिन मैं बिना कैलकुलेटर के कर सकता हूं
नहीं तो तुझे कितना टाइम लगेगा
मेरे को टाइम लगेगा जितना टाइम लगता है 1 टू 100 का एडिशन करने को
ही टाइम गेट्स हाफ इफ यू मेक इट अ कमीशन दैट ही हैज टू गिव टू ओएमएल
लाइक या
नो नो बट आई थिंक इट इज आई थिंक द टोटल इज एंड आई गूगल्ड इट इट इज 50-50 यस I thought it would be much longer. I thought it would be a much bigger number. It's only fucking 50.
But it's 5,050, that's
yeah.
it?
It's 5,050, yeah. 5,050, yeah.
Which is pretty rubbish, dude. Don't please, somebody's trying to give us n factorial formulas. Please, we don't need n factorial into n minus 1.
You think
we
would be comedians if we were doing n factor?
Dude, by the way, you know why my maths became good was because of cricket. Like, and the only thing I know how to do is addition and division.
Run rate.
Because
and
averages
run rate.
And run rate and all that shit. So that's the only reason my maths is good. And then my son is like asking me about triangle kya hota hai. I'm like, you were round wala. He's like, tu kaise shoot?
One sec. Watch this, okay? Varun, what is 368? What is 368? What is 368 plus
464.
368 plus 464.
768. 736.
Yeah. Hey,
you're
useless. Dude, Panth is beating you. Oh, it's early in the morning, Varun. I'll call you at 7:30. No, this Varun is like for everything, you would never imagine how good Varun is at like just basic addition, multiplication, board maths. How good he is at board mass,
brackets, open, division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. You know what I used to actually get fascinated by is you see a lot of these videos where they give you small hacks on how to multiply or how to add and this and that. I used to love that. I don't remember half the shit right now, but school mein na, if you have a good teacher, that's how they'll teach you algebra or not geometry because you can't just triangle and this, but in algebra especially, they would give you these small cheats, so to speak. But yeah, it was so fun because then you have to just shut your eyes, imagine that number and do it. Or my imagination was strong. Yeah.
So dude, I had a very weird fun idea. Is like, I think, I don't know who was discussing, Anubhav was discussing about how Hindustani Bhav should like teach people stuff. And I think this is like the new Shakuntala Bhav. It's just a guy sitting in a car saying, yeah, did you know how to do 43 into 12? Kaise karte hai? Salam. Just like this split.
Idhar nahi aayega.
Tere decimal point ke andar. Sake. Tere factorial se nikale. Just an angry maths teacher. That is the key.
Achha, abhi ek baat bata. 500 Hindu hai. उसके अंदर तूने 350 और हिंदू डाले तो कितने हिंदू है बता। अरे भाव 836
hey, okay, I want to talk about this. Is that let's talk about SNG for a second, because लोगों ने काफी पूछा है. And this is a very interesting question which I've always thought about, which is that तो जब Weird Ass शुरू हुआ, like I think Veer was the only one who had a plan. Okay, where it's like, this is going to happen. With East India Comedy, we were just like, apan log dost hai, saath mein masti karenge. And AIB also was to an extent that. I mean, then it became bigger and bigger. But when this started, it was just like, hey, let's just do. What was the plan with SNG starting?
Same thing. It was literally that. Main aur Karan, hum log mile. And he said, you know, we should start a group. So I said, cool. Because this was 2010. We had done two open mics at that point. So there is no real... place to do it. We are sort of going and speaking to venues ourselves. Like his friend's dad owned that Zoom ek jagah tha na, jidhar hum log karte the. Forget what is it called.
TN.
So he spoke to his friend. Friend's dad hooked us up with the venue and literally jaake perform kar rahe the. And one of these nights we were just discussing, kare group chalu karenge, naam kya rakhe. So he said that he was watching Beer Fest that afternoon. And Beer Fest mein cafe ka naam hai Shits and Giggles. And Shits and Giggles sounds like a very comedy name. It doesn't sound like an accounting firm. So we're like, yeah, cool. Shits and Giggles, that's the name. Literally, the first Shits and Giggles show had Talwar, Kunal Rao, Aditi, Anand Regu, and somebody else. Hum log koi nahi the usme. Because by then, Shits and Giggles is just two people. It was actually Talwar and I. Then we did an open mic at this place called Balthazar in Juhu.
Yeah.
It was a place which has a German name but served Chinese food. And hum log udhar perform kiya, and Bridge was one of the other open micers. And of all the people, including us who performed, Bridge was the only one who killed. Because he had this full proper set, or you know, basically char English line barabar bol sakta hai, right? Without fumbling, it automatically sounds more like, ha, tell me more, what do you want to say? And he was really funny. So hum log jaake usko pucha, hey, why don't you join Shits and Giggles? So he's like, cool, why not? So teen hue. And then with each, like, we started doing some more shows, aise karte gaye. Fir Adar joined us when we were doing this thing called Film Fail Awards. After we split with the Ghantas, we did Film Fail. So Adar came on board on Film Fail. So he became a part of it. Baba came right after Adar, I think. Ha, Baba? You'd come.
Oh, right. No. I called Adar and said, let's do improv. Do you want to do improv first? Because I had asked Bridge that, do you want to do improv? So then I called Adar, said we'll do improv, come join the collective and stuff like that. I couldn't do Film Fail, but we weren't a collective at that point. You all had done Film Fail as SNG. We were starting to do improv after that. But then again, getting our time together is a joke. So then we
that's sort literally of how it happened. And I remember Kautuk, because Baba used to work at MTV and he had created this show called Rock the Vote.
No, Rock the Vote's a property. We created one new show in Rock the Vote.
Baba, main kitna khush kar raha hu tereko bol ke property de raha, apni story kuch bhi bole tereko kya hai? Tu kyun apne itne acche, maine description diya us pe baja rahe apni. Anyway,
Baba, you're a very creative guy, man, and I think Rock the Vote is an amazing property, and I think you're just a good dude, you know.
And on that property, we needed somebody to write, because Khamba aur main kar raha tha, aur Neville aur Jose. But we needed someone to write. Aur ye sala idhar hai na Kautuk. मेरे को कौतुक पहले से पसंद है, because by the way, कौतुक has been performing and doing open mic since he was 18. ठीक है?
Really?
Yeah, he was 18 and I remember him performing at a bunch of the open mics used to happen earlier, Cafe Goa times. So I suddenly remembered him, और मैंने उसको Facebook पे message किया कि yo bro, are you still writing nowadays? Blah blah blah. ऐसा opportunity है, are you interested? तो कौतुक ऐसे interested and he came and we started writing together. बस वो दैट वाज द लास्ट स्ट्रो देन फाइनली एसएनजी फाउंड अ राइटर अपन वी वेंट थ्रू फाइव मेंबर्स बट नो राइटर्स एंड देन कौतुक को लिया फिर अच्छा नाउ वी कैन डू सम ओरिजिनल राइटिंग बिकॉज़ कौतुक आ गया ऐसे हो गया था एंड दैट्स हाउ इट केम टू बी
It's so random though, man. Everything is so goddamn random. Like none of this had an intention. It was just like, yeah. masti karte. And I think it's a bit of a mistake that you make specifically young in your career, where the first thing you think about when you're either, and creativity can be in a startup also. You could be doing a fucking media startup and still be creative.
Correct.
And I just think that young people, including us, make that sort of mistake of like, so I was thinking about the format of East India Comedy, right? And I thought about two things. One is that, One thought in my head was that it should have just been a core team of four people and then other people come and freelance and do whatever the fuck it was.
Mm.
Now, the problem with that is that if that had been the case, which sucks. And also more importantly, if that had been the case, then there's a very high likelihood that East India Comedy wouldn't be around right now. So, I mean, either or, it's a slightly weird situation. With SNG, though, were you guys happy with the work you did?
Yeah.
Dude, honestly, even now when we open, you'll open up your Facebook or something, they'll show you videos from back in the day. And without stroking our own thing, let me tell you, I actually genuinely feel we did some really funny work. I mean, yeah, some of it was not good, but that's bound to happen. Right? You put 10 things out, there might be 2-3 that don't work, but there were a few of them that I thought was genuine gold. It was really good stuff, right from the writing to the acting to the way the sketch came about to the idea also.
Dude, there was a sketch show we were doing called Gandu Nights. I mean, Gandu Nights is one of the best sketch shows. Like, I mean, genuinely from the outside, you'll see. Like, the last sketch, we can never perform live. Even now, we can't ever perform that sketch live. Right? Like, in the current environment.
Because we don't want to be lynched.
Yeah.
Oh, I know the bit. I've seen the bit. I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
It's important. And parallelly on the side, Bridge, Adar and I also did Shakespeare, where we got the rights to do complete works of William Shakespeare abridged, right? And we did the whole play. We put it up and stuff. So, I mean, genuinely speaking, I think that there was some great work out there. Yeah. Like, genuinely. Like
one sketch we had written in 2015. It was called More Like Social Travels. Okay, and the idea was that why travel when you can just Photoshop yourself into places, right? And that sketch was, that idea was later done by John Oliver. And when the...
True story.
Exact same thing. And then when the pandemic happened, right? You can't travel. So that sketch got a second burst of virality and it's still relevant.
And funnily enough, if you see it on the YouTube channel, it has 5 lakh views. But I know a million people who have sent it to me on WhatsApp saying, bro, we got it on our group. So it became viral in a very different, not your traditional YouTube 5 million views, but it became super popular on the on WhatsApp, especially.
So, no, but just coming back to that point that you were making, Saurabh, that the fact that, like, you know, it starts from nowhere, but then it becomes a structure. Right, like it becomes like this way of doing things. And I think that's completely, it's like there is no true way of doing things. Like anything that has ever become something has started from literally, ki chal kuch karte hain. You know, because there is, you know, there is a void that I want to fill particularly and I enjoy doing this, that's why I'm doing it. And then it becomes like
You know, but I honestly think like it doesn't matter what your process is.
Yeah, exactly.
Like what your reasons, what your process, what the way is in which you're doing whatever you want to do. My thing is like the minute you start comparing, hey, you see guys X, they are doing that. We should do that. No, guys X are doing that because it works for them. Or guy Y is doing that because it works for their team. But if we as A have a few things that we can't iron out or change, then we have to adapt to that. There is no, you can't force somebody. We've all become comedians because we like comedy. That's the first thing, right? You like to do comedy. Secondly, your process of, acha, teko subah 9 baje milna hai, ya raat ko 8 baje milna hai, ya 3 baje milna hai, milenge agar sabko milna hai. You know what I mean? So I think that amount of flexibility and camaraderie when you have, everything falls into place because you don't have to be a startup with, okay, we need HR team, we need an accounts division, we need this. You don't. You really, really don't. Not in today's world. I personally feel you don't. For the kind of stuff we are doing. I'm not saying an actual startup with a with whatever apps and all of that. None of that. But for a comedy collective, the 5, 6, 7, 8, how many of you are there? I think you should find a process that works for you best, which means, okay, we know Neville's going to be working in the afternoon because he has a fucking big job to do at Ogilvy. You know, Kautuk is writing because he gets 80 things to write, whether it's a show, it's whatever the fuck it is, right? So you have to figure out, ki, achha, tu free nahi hai, tu abhi free hai. Now let's figure out, come to a point, okay, 7 o'clock, everybody is free, we'll meet there.
No, it's not just that. Also, there's two other things that we do fairly well. Like, I think there was one decision at some point we took at SNG saying that, look, we're not going to be able to, and this was fairly late after we had done sketches for about 3-4 years, etc. Where we were like, okay, it's very difficult for us to coordinate and sort of give proper tips. So whatever we do, which is the genesis of BigQuest, whatever we do, let's do it like improvised, because we're great as people who collectively, when we talk, it's fun. We know what we're talking about, etc., etc. And so we're able to do it. So whenever we do stuff, we'll try and do improvised stuff together. And that's the genesis of even what Big Question was.
So, but also to add to the Big Question thing, right? Big Question was not like, we didn't come to Big Question as, oh, this is going to change our lives or anything.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely not. Exactly.
And that's the other thing that, like, I feel like if you're a young creator, do the stuff that you want to do because you want to do it, not because iska audience hai. Yeah. You figure an audience if you're good at it and you like doing it. There's always a fucking audience.
The best example is my channel. Like,
it'll take 20 years, but eventually you'll get an audience. You will. Yeah, yeah. Do it passionately.
So the best example is my channel, which is Neville Cooks Things, then it's Stream for Sanity, then it's something else. Yeah, wo.
We used to keep having, every time you had every second East India comedy meeting, there would be some reference, and usually from a person who I won't name, whose name is Sapan, about like, are, but AIB did this and we should do this. I don't know if you guys are having the same meetings where everybody's
of
like, yeah, AIB did this, so we should also do this.
We had one person.
That's it.
And it's like, it's very easy to, especially in the world you live in, right? Where on every time you open social media, you see your peers doing something else and getting.
Yeah.
And it's very easy to get seduced by that kind of thing, right? Chal, main bhi ye karta hoon. And you never end up doing what you want to fucking do.
Yeah.
It's very hard to kind of like cut the distractions out.
Yeah, because I think look, it's a good thing, because Sapan is always a very cordial and friendly guy, and he's aware of what's happening in the industry, so that's very important. But I do think that sometimes we were trying to be that which wasn't in our zone. I think when EIC finally did the two properties that I think which we finally sort of quote unquote established who we were, one was to an extent Ghantas. And the second was EIC Outrage. And EIC Outrage was specifically because I was like, this has to happen. This is something that fucking I feel strongly about. And I've been doing news comedy in some format since 2006. So we have to fucking do this. Mm. And everybody was on board very quickly, which is like rare for all of us to be on the same page. Even though, by the way, I know I'm talking about EIC like this, we are still the best of friends. And this is conversations that we've had multiple times. I'm talking about collectives that are not best of friends. I have to ask you though about, I mean, KT ke bare mein, we've heard the story of like all this, all that. I'm sure you guys have spoken about it on the podcast and all. But you haven't?
No. You've never? Just done one statement and then think, like, it's pointless trying to kharocho it. There's no real reason to sort of like think. So we didn't speak about it. I mean, everybody to each his own is really what we believe. We zen it out.
The statement we put out was quite honest and was actually the full story. There's nothing more that we can add to it. So it was...
We can, but we don't need to.
Yeah.
There's no need for mudslinging and washing laundry in public. We said what we had to, because that had to be said, because we overtook.
Yeah.
Our viewers who watch our stuff, who are expecting something to continue and then suddenly put a stop to it. So they deserve to know. And we told them about what we felt was necessary for them to know. Other all the salacious details to offline another go bata de.
Yeah, but I agree. I completely agree. I think there's no purpose of like talking yeah. about all this shit. Like, it's like, and also, why do you want to send it in the universe? You want to send like positive, happy, yeah. stupid shit. So,
dude,
yeah.
see, no, we no, are doing
also,
our own
I think that, yeah,
we are doing our own thing. We are happy.
Like, I mean, to each his own. Yeah, I mean,
sab log khush raho. And I think we are all happier the way we are right now. You know what I mean? So,
yeah.
if that in itself is half the stress gone. So, why let him do what he wants? We'll do what we want. Sab log khush raho, yaar.
Yeah.
Talking about sending happy shit to the universe, Neville has to leave. So, dekha kya connection kya maine? Segue number one.
I have to. This isn't even a segue. You should hear Varun trying to make a segue from the introduction. So, this you realize. So, by the way, I have to go on work calls, but just before I go, guys, episode has dropped. 12 o'clock has happened. Oh, shit.
It's already started.
Oh, God.
आ रहा है ना हाँ भाई पॉडकास्ट निकल गया जाके देखो 12 बज गए
and Neville is internet is computed the perfectly right now.
Yeah.
So this is all working out nice.
सुनाई नहीं दे रहा क्या अभी
नहीं
नहीं I don't know what's happening. Hey, can you guys hear me now or no? Is this
no,
still
Baba,
not working?
Baba, we don't want to hear you. Jana.
Okay. Bye, guys. Thank you so much. Bye. See you.
Okay, I'll just see some super chats and then we'll come back to this. A lot of things to talk about. Mohammed Akib says, I was watching Shaitan Haveli for the fifth time yesterday. I just want to thank Kautuk and Varun for making it. Neville, OP and where is Adar? We've answered where is Adar.
Thank you, yaar. Very sweet of you. Please spread the love. Sabko jaake dikhao ye show. Matlab, bahut mehnat gayi thi hamari isme. So, really happy to hear people watch that show. Because even nowadays, right, if I meet somebody and you know, you get complimented for your work, I get most excited when people tell me about Shaitan Haveli first. I mean, mera stand-up nahi, mera baki acting nahi, podcast nahi, ye nahi, wo nahi. Shaitan bolta because Kautuk and I know what we did to be able to pull that off in how much ever we did.
Oh shit, we should do this. Saurabh, so the last episode, the last finale episode of Shaitan Haveli was written on WhatsApp.
No, and I'll tell you how. Okay. Because it's so quick, we've written 8 episodes, sent it. Production ke paas hai, director ke paas hai, sab ke paas hai. Then, the day before I'm leaving obviously early because I'm showrunner, so I got to be there from day minus one, right? Yeah. So, we're leaving and production and director take me to the side. They're like, bro, there's a bit of a problem. I said, the last episode is a little tough to do now that we think about it. Because what we had written as last episode is portal khulta hai aur portal ke andar se bhoot aate hai alag alag. Theek hai? Bahut, matlab, it was supposed to be an action sequence on the battlefield in a village ki regular dhoti wali public aur samne se bhoot aa rahe. Aur ye aisa hoga, fir ye karenge. And then they all looked at it, they're like, bhai, ye nahi ho raha hai. Theek hai, apne paas jitne paise hai, usme se mushkil se hum log khatam kar pa rahe hai. Ye to chance hi nahi hai. And I'm like, fuck, what to do? And I've reached the location now. Said, okay, gotta change it. Lekin mera laptop chal raha hai. Production laptop set pe, main hotel room mein baitha. I'm like, fuck, kya karu? I've called Kautuk. I said, Kautuk, let's jam. I'm not a jam. I said, I'm writing it on WhatsApp. I don't know if he still has the chat. Mere phone badle uske baad. But wo chat pe literally sare beat points likhe. And because Kautuk and I have such a good working relationship, he knows what I want. I know what he wants. उसको मैंने व्हाट्सएप भेजा उसने शाम तक उसको फाइनल ड्राफ्ट में स्क्रिप्ट फॉर्मेट में लिख के भेजा है बट दैट फर्स्ट डिस्कशन वाज एंटायरली ऑन स्नैपचैट स्नैपचैट आई एम सेइंग ऑन व्हाट्सएप
या द होल लाइक द होल थिंग वाज देयर द होल आउटलाइन ऑन व्हाट्सएप एंड देन यू नो यू हैड टू जस्ट फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स इट वाज क्रेजी
बट हाउ डिड यू शो इट टू एक्टर्स यू आर लाइक हां आपका अगला डायलॉग एक सेंटेंस लेट मी सेंड इट टू यू एंड देन दे आर लाइक
द बेस्ट थिंग वाज दैट इट ऑन अ शो लाइक दिस ऑल योर फ्लॉज एंड मिस्टेक्स can be disguised as deliberate. So like, there are some things we did on purpose. Like all of these B-grade movies would have a lot of continuity jumps, right? Ki ek scene mein baal chote, ek mein lamba hua. I actually did that. There's a scene where I'm talking to the main villain, jab mere baal lambe-ish hai. When I say lambe, as in like, I've got a good head full of hair. Next scene mein, literally next line mein, baal chote. And people have commented, hey bro, in that scene, I'm like, yeah, it was on purpose. But there were a lot of other mistakes that weren't on purpose. It was a mistake. But you can tell the cast, ki, are, hum log janmuch ke kar rahe. Are, mera pant phata hai, nahi ho janmuch ke.
Also, like, because it was that B grade, no, not even B, Z grade horror space, right? Like the research for Shaitan Haveli was probably the most fun I've had ever. Because things like, what is it? Pyasi Chudel.
Dude, we watched a shit ton of Z-grade movies more. But even just to know how these Ramses went about accomplishing whatever they did in the 80s. I'll tell you the funnest fact of them all. In 1984, in a year that had two Amitabh Bachchan movies, the second highest grossing movie of that year was Purani Haveli.
Yeah.
Of the year, not highest grossing in B grade, highest grossing in that year was Purani Haveli. It had Monish Bhel and Puneet Issar.
Wow.
Directed by the Ramsey brothers.
And you know the thing about like one of the things that we at least tried to get into the show was the heart of what the Ramsey project was.
Yeah.
These
guys were just passionate people operating at the height of their talent, okay, and just producing whatever the fuck came out, and it was just fun for them to do it.
Dude, they were like, you remember how we used to be in 2014 jab apne ko sketch banane ka tha?
Yeah.
Kuch bhi tu acha Saurabh tu aaj direct bhi kar, Sahil tu aaj makeup bhi kar raha hai, tu costume bhi hai, are Atul tu aaj, so you would all sort of come together and just make it happen because your channel needed content and views. Literally the same thing.
Yeah.
Except they, YouTube pe nahi ja rahe hain log.
It was like a family picnic that they went on and produced horror movies. Like that's what it was like.
That's what they actually said also.
Yeah.
So the entire cast and crew used to go in a bus. Including the lead actors. Sab bus mein the. Khana banta tha family ke koi aadmi. Dude, they had a brother who was a DOP. Who didn't know how to shoot.
Gangu.
He learned on set. Because camera ke saath manual aa raha hai na, toh manual ko pakke. This is what was happening. And they made that shit work, dude. And they made a name for themselves. So it was crazy just to learn and read about these people. Insane.
Dude, but like, I mean, Varun, like, it's a very, I spoke to Biswa and I spoke to Kenny about this also. And Biswa told me outright, he's like, I'm not acting in a show that I'm a showrunner and writer.
Yeah.
And Kenny told me roughly the same thing when I think he did Die Trying, yeah. Where you're like, dude, it's just crazy amount of effort and you just can't do it. How the fuck did you manage? Like, it must have been a crazy amount of effort to do all three things.
Bro, so basically, June 1st, 2017 to Jan 6, 2018, my life was only Shaitan. I didn't do much else. Wiki video. Shaitan writing or whatever, pre-production or the actual shoot or the post and edit and the off corporate show here and there. This was literally it. My whole life was that. And what I realized is because I was anyway so passionate about this show in general that I didn't feel the workload, although there was a lot. We were shooting 18-hour days for 23 days that we were there. Just khich raha 18-hour days. 16 ghanta, you're in makeup, it's hot, udhar aag laga hai, mashal hai, you know what I mean? To give that horror wala feel. So you're constantly next to a fucking mashal. And you got to shoot your scene, then go behind, look on the monitor and see, okay, ye acha lag raha hai, nahi lag raha hai. So in that case, I think the one thing that really helps is if you have a good director and a good production team. So at least I'm not getting involved in those aspects. I'm just like, main creatively dekhega kya hai. Baki, sir, mashal nahi aaya. Sir, Chudel ka naak barabar fit nahi ho raha hai. That's your lookout.
Yeah.
I won't do that. But yeah, I think those 6 months, dude, have just sort of transformed me from the inside because now I'm like, I can do this. Because pehle I would jokingly say, sala koi picture mein le raha hai nahi, lagta hai mujhe khud ke liye picture likhna pade. I have to Stallone it.
No, but that's the point, Saurabh. So the other thing is that Varun is an actor first. So for him, the other stuff is the problem.
Right. Yeah. But very few, like Sumukis pulled it off, Zakir pulled it off, Anirban decided not to get involved. But it's very interesting that you do both. Here's a very random question, okay? Which is, I think people don't realize this, that the first time you ever make your own TV show, and in your head you're like, "Arey, TV show bana, ye log to ameer ho gaye," and you are not.
No, bro, public ko lagta apan YouTube se millionaire ban rahe, theek hai? With the amount of views and, aray, you guys make so much money on YouTube. I said, nahi, bhai, teko dikhata ho accounts. Dekho, kitna kam paisa haath mein aata hai. We've not afforded proper sound stuff.
The weirdest thing was, after the red card came out, in the Google search, suddenly Kautuk Shrivastava's net worth happened. I was like, that's the weirdest time to add net worth after you've written a book. Because if anything, lost money.
I'm going to check this right now. I'm going to check all our net worths right now. Let's see. What is your net worth? 1 million. Oh, 1 million to 5 million. What the fuck, dude?
What's the net worth?
Varun Thakur kitna dekhte hain. But Kautuk is like fucking 1 million and all.
1 to 5 million.
That's very vague, yaar. Kuch to matlab specific karke rakho. How is everybody 1 to 5 million?
2018, approx net worth was 100,000 to 1 million. और अभी इन 2019 इज 1 मिलियन तो ये किसने लिखा है ना उसको पहले बोलना पड़े 1 मिलियन डॉलर 7.5 खोका है ठीक है 5 मिलियन इज 7.5 खोका इनटू 5
कैश
ठीक है दैट्स 350 मिलियन
या डूड इट्स लाइक 50
करोड़ यू थिंक इफ आई हैड 350 करोड़
या
यू थिंक that I would be wearing these free headsets I bought from a brand deal.
यार हम लोग के जो काफी वीडियोस एडिट करता है जयंत तो जयंत तो लाइक सर बहुत एम्बैरेसिंग लग रहा है कि आप अभी भी ईयरफोन्स में ये सारे अभी 27 वीडियो हो गए हैं एंड ही लाइक आप खरीद लो रहा एंड ही लाइक ही सेंड मी अ लिंक ऑफ 8000 रुपीस लाइक वो उसने बोला कि आप अगले महीने भी दे सकते हो आई एम लाइक नहीं मैं गरीब हूं अभी मेरे बच्चों की सैलरी
You're paying them for being your kids. मेरा बच्चा बनेगा per month.
पापा per diem कितना है?
सारा wish fulfillment is so strong. He's like, I can't wait for these fuckers to earn their money.
उसका per diem homework है bro.
Dude, even the figures of estimated YouTube revenue is like some other thing only. It's anything. It's saying that I'm earning $9,000 per month on YouTube in July. Fuck off, dude. I wish I was at least 9,000.
Varun Thakur,
you can check yours also. It's there. There's a i.e.youtube. It's absolute rubbish, dude. I'm not making this much. What are you talking about? Okay, I know you guys have to go, right? You guys have to bounce, right?
Yeah.
Nee, mera is bang on because this. So it's, I've opened it, okay? And it says, my global rank is 98,536. Okay, global rank. उसके बाद एवरेज व्यूज इज 90,000 एस्टिमेटेड मंथली अर्निंग्स $110
and that's not including how much like manager takes and no, so effectively no, like $10 are for Thakur's YouTube earnings of 500-700 rupees he's killing it dude
and you wonder why I don't have a proper mic that's why
yeah. Wait, I want to see what my overall ranking is dude this is exciting I don't know There's an overall ranking and all. No, yeah, nothing. Fuck it.
98,207 clash.
Okay, there are a lot of super chat questions since you guys have to bounce. Let's do two line answers.
Yeah.
जल्दी से करते हैं. Gaurav Arora, oh damn, this means a lot because it's Tuesday. This is the reason lockdown was bearable and now you too, Saurabh. I couldn't imagine four guys in a podcast could seem like my friends. We are your friends forever. friends help each other out. Chirag Shetty, Shaitan Haveli, and Don't Come Last, highly underrated. Don't Come Last is that game show you did.
Yeah.
Huh.
Bro, bahut mast show tha yaar, time pass show. So basically, many people don't know, but I used to do a show. So my first foray into TV, etc. was right after I came back from university. It was a show I used to do on Bindas. Okay. Huh. Our wo show, it was an Indian remake, official remake of this Canadian show called Kenny versus Penny. It's two dudes who stay together and they keep challenging each other through random tasks. Jo hara, wo punish hoega by the winner. Simple, yeah. Straightforward. So that was my first foray in. It was called
Sin. Can I tell you something? Can I tell you something? I was also supposed to do that show with you.
Kya baat kar raha?
Yeah. So then, and then, us time pe, I think either there was a date clash or a money clash or some crap like that. I don't know what happened. And I think this was like fucking 2009. Yeah, so I remember they said this Varun Thakur guy is there. I'm like, who the fuck is Varun Thakur? Excuse me, I will not perform for anyone less than Amitabh Bachchan or Ajay Devgan. Those are my two set points. Now, the first one, what is it?
So, we did that show. The one thing that really stood out in that show is people love seeing other people get fucked. So, right, if three of us are playing, and at the end of this live, one of us is going to get jacked, right, by doing whatever it always works. So we were trying to come up with some random fiction show, non-fiction show idea for Amazon. Kya kare? So we all brainstormed and we're like, we'll do this show. Jabhi, it's called the title. I love the title because it's literally what the show is about. ki just don't come last. Because if you come last, you're going to get fucked. Now, what we did is we took 12 episodes divided between four of us. We all host three episodes each. So say it's my episode. I will design the three rounds in that episode. So it'll be a physical round. It'll be a performance round, something or the other, right? Which is fun to watch. Like there was stuff like you wear boxing gloves, but make a sandwich and you have a time.
Yeah, I've seen it. Yeah.
So it's a combination of a lot of things you've seen, but with our own twist to it. And jo bhi episode mein jo bhi hara, he gets punished by the other three winners. So we've had some glorious moments in that. Public cross-dress kiya hai, waxing kiya hai, tweezing eyebrows kiya hai, kuch weird concoction of shit we've had to drink. We've already spoken about this, but this one I will talk again because Kautuk, that is by far the best thing ever. Theek hai? So a game tha usme, you have to put your head on a bat. Guys, don't try this at home unless you want to faint. Head on a bat and you take 10 circles around the bat. Aise karke goal karte hai. Then you get up and there's an easel with a mathematical problem. You have to go there and solve the math problem. That's it. Bro, Kautuk ne kiya das. He has walked. This is the easel, okay? He has walked. And because it puts your head in such a spin, woh chalte chalte na, he has just walked and fallen.
I walked off the set.
He has walked straight and... Because itna chakkar aa raha hai, dude. It is...
Fuck, it'll be hilarious if next door like Simi Garewal is shooting. And then through the curtains, this one guy's like, why do you feel... I just like just get completely fucking the whole
thing. Dude, it was like being like outside Gokul on a Saturday, right? Like...
Except you've had all of Gokul.
Yeah, I've had all of
Gokul.
Talking about things that you can't get on Gokul, here's a question for Kautuk, which is that Vishal Arora has asked, aaj Kautuk kaun sa juice pee raha hai?
Aaj main pee raha hu garam pani aur neebu.
Oh, your laptop.
Table pe gira, thank you.
This is like he's still giddy from that cricket thing. Jayant Kaushik has said, so,
Yeah, 10 minutes.
Because I know you have to bounce. Ashish Shane says, hi, I'm Ayushi. I've made a sweatshirt based on this interest fund. Thanks a lot, guys. We appreciate it, man. Hey, thanks to you also.
Thank you. Thank you for watching.
Ashish B, thanks a lot. Anchit says, from a distance, this looks like SNG reunion. We've already covered this joke. Vivek Tajuja says, need a books episode. Also seeing Kautuk after ages. So, hey, Kautuk. Thakur is hot. I think it is the Sindhi genes that make him look like this. I am being silly now. Great work, Payat.
Thank you. Ayo lal kayo jule lal.
A book episode is going to happen. I am in touch with quite a few authors and we are going to have a book episode either this week or the next. But my plan was to do a book episode with authors every week. But I'm working on it. It'll happen. Don't worry, friends. Okay, then... Vivek Madi has given SCK50 says, I love the TIS podcast. They're hilarious. Again, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
And Kuch Bhi Mehta, our friend Akash Mehta asked, thoda random, but I remember Varun telling me once that he used to do 10 to 16,000 steps when he did that SRK movie. How do you keep up physically? Oh, what a question.
Bro, I have done nothing during this lockdown. Nothing.
Sorry, I have to get my charger. So I'm just putting my video off, but I can hear you very clearly.
So I think during the lockdown, I haven't done shit. No workout at all. I think my max workout has been jhadu pocha. Main beech mein ek din, oh shit, this is a funny story. Okay, it's in the one of the days in the middle, I was like, thoda kuch workout karna chahiye, body is sust. So we've decided to go running. Theek hai? So that time we weren't allowed to go out. So I was running, jogging in my building. Finished jogging in the building, I'm like, building mein maza nahi aa raha, machhar kaat raha hai. So I want to go to Lokhandwala back road to run. And hey, I'm not chilling with anybody. I'm not close to anybody. I'm wearing my mask and doing my own thing. It should be okay. Back road pe bhaag raha na, seedha Pandu ne pakad liya. Pandu, ikade, kai chalu hai? Ha? Kute challa? I said, sir, kute challa? Matlab jogging ke liye ja raha hai. Allowed nahi hai. Bro, they have made me sign a declaration saying, Marathi mein likha hai, vina karan bhatakne. Bina baat ke bhatak raha hai, basically, to translate. Usme likha hai Marathi mein that the police had caught me for just randomly walking on the street without any reason. And I sincerely apologize for my actions. And I hereby agree that if they catch me again, and put me in jail, I do not have a problem with that. to paraphrase, it's not exactly that. Paraphrase. This is pretty much what happened. उसके बाद मैं भागा ही नहीं, workout ही नहीं किया उसके बाद, छोड़ दिया. ऐसे छोड़ चाहिए नहीं.
But dude, this fitness thing is a very, very weird thing, man. I've realized that the more fitter you are, the more shit you get done. It's just that simple.
Yeah, that's true. And the thing with, I think, fitness also, right? It working out, especially of any kind, to yoga, running, proper gym, whatever you do. I feel that even when you do that in the day and you don't particularly do work.
Yeah.
In your head, you feel you've done work. And I think that's, especially for people, I mean, not now because of COVID, but otherwise, you know, people like us, we've been working from home only, man. It's not like we were going to an office, right? And there are times when we'll just be sitting and nothing funny is coming. Your laptop is open, your Word doc, final draft is just open with nothing typed. And I think war time with that workout, the endorphins that it releases, it's actually gotten me through really dark, like, writer's block days. You know, like, because you start really judging and you start thinking that, okay, wait, I'm not funny, I've lost it. You know what I mean? You go into that weird spiral. And like, the only thing that had helped me out then was working out. So, gotta get back to that.
And also, like, as a writer, I can tell you, you need to fucking get working on your back, on your lower back. Because it is the number one thing you need as a writer. It is the number one, it's very underrated. How much you
need. I mean, you need the rest of your body also. I mean, it's not like, because you can't, it's very hard to type with your lower back.
I don't need a book.
You can't be like using your lumbar support and be like, yeah, chill, yeah, cute type. I'd be
surprised how little you can type with a bad one. It's unbearable.
Dude, but keeping the darkness out with exercise, man. Fuck, I completely, there were like 2 weeks in the middle where I was not exercising at all. And the thoughts in my head were fucked. And I'm like, I can't deal with this.
I know, that's the thing. And when you know that, that's the good part of working out. And it, you know how it makes you feel post. And you're like, hey, I want to feel this every day. Still, somehow, after doing it for months, there comes a time when I start making excuses to myself. Yeah, theek hai, abhi kar liya na, abhi ho gaya body. You know what I mean? Like, and this has happened to me for 14 years. From my first time I worked out when I was 17 to I'm 33 now. 16 saal, sorry. 16 years. Has been the same story. You work out, team mehnat kiya, thoda bhi ise cut word dikha, ek ab aa gaya, done, sorted, pizza, burger, soega late. This, you know, I can't make up one excuse to go to the gym, but I have 1,000 to not go.
Yeah.
Like, it just...
I push myself like crazy right now. Like today morning, I was like 15 minute hai mera beech mein, and I'm doing like fuck all forearm exercises. Like I'm like, kuch bhi kar raha hai. Like thoda wo kya hota hai? What is that thing which makes you happy? Whatever the fuck it's called. What is that fucking chemical?
Endorphins.
Okay, Vivek Madhyas, I love the Tis podcast. The hilarious already said. Nahi, ye to ho gaya. Sandpaper Napkin says the team shared an idea of a B grade horror movie title generator site. On the podcast when the show released, I worked on it and received 100 plus visits per day. Thanks for giving me a great side project. That's very cool, man.
Wow. Who's this?
That's damn cool. Sandpaper Napkin. Dude, share it with Varun and this one on Instagram. That sounds fucking great.
So weird that we're hearing about it here.
Insane. We also have a channel,
Neeraj Krishnan, thanks a lot for your $10. Appreciate, man. You want to get Mehta for 10 minutes? I think you guys have to bounce, no?
Yeah.
So, Inosuke Hashibira, this is the last question. How did you create the Vicky Malhotra character? I'm assuming you've answered this multiple times.
Yes, but I will happily answer it again because now it's just stuck in my head. So, fun fact, many, many years ago, this Vicky started in 2016. My then manager said, you have to do something. Tera kuch content nahi aa raha, because I was only doing vines at that point.
Yeah.
So she said, try doing something. Riya Dhanda, who used to manage me then. So she said, you know, I think you should try and do a character because I've seen you do characters. It works. And that's what's working nowadays outside. So try a character. So I was literally at home trying to do the Vicky character without Vicky. There was no face. It was just me with sunglasses. And the voice of Vicky was basically my impression of Akshay Kumar from Gandu Night sketch show. Okay. So I'm like, okay, cool. I'll use that. Now, I tried doing it just with my face, not working, because you can still see my face. Then I found face swap on Snapchat.
Yeah.
I'm like, great. I'll have to just swap with somebody. So, I went to Google. और पंजाबी मेल मॉडल टाइप किया लिटरली. And then a barrage of pictures open and I just save, right click, save, 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 save. I have about 50 odd pictures on my phone. Now, one by one, I'm trying everybody. Picture number 32 or 33 was this dude. And it fit. Bro, it fits like this guy was made for me. Because the jawline, the head, this, everything just fit. I was like, perfect. So, video banaya. Many years later, a year and a half later, I found out who he actually is. I won't tell you. But he's not an actor from India. I can tell you that much.
But yeah, he's a famous actor.
I had no idea, bro. I had a Punjabi male model. I thought there will be a new rapper that I haven't heard of. Fuck it, I'll put it.
So recently,
it turned out to be.
We were doing a new show called Takedown. Okay, usme we had to, there was one section where we had to do something with Akshay Kumar's voice. So, we go like, hey, Varun, why don't you do your Akshay Kumar voice? He does it. We're like, no, that's Vicky. He's like, shut up. Akshay Kumar.
Dude, we have such limited range, okay, as people. There, I used to do a character called Saurabh Pan, right?
Uh-huh.
And Saurabh Pan, the idea was that...
It was the Sardar, no? That was the Sardar.
No, Sardar was Panjot Singh Sidhu. Yeah, it's all these fuck all puns. And so Saurabh Pan was literally the pun thing. And I was like, I need a voice for this character where it was based on Mitch Hedberg instead of me walking sideways as most comedians do. The thing in my head which would make it different was he walks front and back for no reason. And I was like, what is the voice? And then I was like, fine, his voice is Saif Ali Khan. So it's just me on stage, dressed as Mitch Hedberg, going like, guys, does anybody know, guys, has anybody read Jitendra's new book? It's called The Devil Wears Jaya Prana. And all this bullshit. And it was just, the voice is so fucking dumb that people are like, is this, I don't understand if this joke is good. But yeah, thanks a lot for your time. I know you guys have to bounce. Do you guys have anything happening to plug, push, anything?
Yes, our podcast has just released simultaneously on our channel. We've also launched a new show called Takedown. We did a North America tour last weekend and we're going to be adding a few more shows for India, Middle East, Australia, etc. So please buy tickets and come watch. Other than that, please just create dummy accounts and start following our Instagram page. And we need more followers, man. That's about
my book. I keep it on my desk just to promote it on Saurabh.
You know, I'm going to order a copy now. I already have one, but I'm going to order one more copy just as payment for this podcast.
Hey, but Saurabh, thank you, man. This was a lot of fun. I'm glad we were able to connect properly this time and not over WhatsApp video call. Yeah.
Dude, we have to do it again. And next time we'll talk. Let's do cricket. Yeah, let's do a cricket thing and let's do internet setso combo podcast.
Ah,
and then that'll be fun.
Yeah,
that'll be like weird.
100%.
Awesome. I'm just going to say the goodbyes for today. So if you guys want to bounce, you can please bounce.
Thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in. Thanks, Pandy. Bye.
Thanks, Kautuk. Thanks to Neville. Yeah. Thanks to other. Will come next time. Don't worry about it. I just want to thank a few people again. I have a show coming up on 16th August. So you can get tickets on saurabhpan.com. End the video.
Yeah.
Saurabh.com is tickets and tomorrow's a holiday break from the show. Thursday we have Joy Bhattacharya, ex-team director of KKR, and I think one comedian. There is a very high possibility that comedian may be the comedian in the chat whose name happens to be Akash Mehta. And one more person also we'll get. And we'll do talking about cricket and the IPL and stuff like that on Thursday. I'll announce Saturday ka abhi tak. I honestly got a little lazy, but I will figure out somebody for Saturday. I just want to thank a few people who gave our Insta mojo to keep this podcast going. Kavarpreet Singh, Monica, Manak Singh, Salman, Bhaswar Arya. Double thanks to Bhaswar Arya. You're a great person. Jaydev Singh, Siddhi Nair, Neil Prabh. Double thanks to Neil Prabh. You're a great person. Amrit Vijaydas, Sinish Malikal, Tarun, Anshul Sharma. And big thanks to Urvash. Urvash, thanks a lot. Also on PayPal, a couple of people gave. Thanks a lot to them. Abhimanyu Kamath, Roshan Rutre, who's given before. Thanks a lot once again. Kritika Nagpal, Badrinath Katare, and Ashish Srivastav. In the comments also, let me know who you'd like to see next. I'm trying to get in touch with a lot of people, by the way. So a lot of the people you've recommended and put on the comments or in posts, I have tried to get. We will try and get as many people as we can. Get Rajdeep Sir this way. Okay, I'll try. I'm trying. I know somebody pointed out that there's too many left wingers and get some right wingers. I mean, I don't really see everybody as that, but I'm trying to figure out somebody as well. I'm doing some research and trying to get in touch with a bunch of people, irrespective of, I really don't give a that much of a shit about people's political beliefs. Thanks a lot to everybody tuning in, man, and everybody who gave us super chat. See, today we covered every super chat possible. However, it's not possible in every single podcast. Today, these guys were nice enough to hang around and do it. Go to Varun Thakur's channel, subscribe. Go to Neville's channel, subscribe. Follow them on Instagram, all the rest of that shit. And keep putting in the comments who you'd like to see next, and I will try and get them. That's about it, guys. Nothing else to plug. I'll see you guys on Thursday. Thanks a lot. You're great people. Love you all. Marry me. Goodbye. And thanks to Manav and Niharika again.